I'm Becky, and today I'm going over L-Arginine, L-Citrulline. I put out a short about both of these, and there was a ton of traffic in the comments, people complaining about one or the other, saying I got it wrong. I'm doing a deep dive today, all the recent studies, how to use it, what I use personally, the pros and cons of each one.
A popular uses for erectile dysfunction, is it as good as Viagra and other supplements?
How should you use them? Are they worth taking? Do they do anything for peripheral arterial disease? Anything for athletes? And we're starting now. L-arginine and L-citrulline are both amino acids that play important roles in the body, particularly in the production of nitric oxide, which is critical for healthy blood flow and heart health. Especially for my patients who have peripheral arterial disease, this may be an option, or is it?
The Heart Research Institute shows that 50% of people over the age of 40 will develop arteriosclerosis. That's horrible. That's really bad in society. And what nitric oxide does is it works on the endothelial vessels in our arteries and actually opens them up so that they get more blood flow. Take a look here. On the left-hand side is before nitric oxide, and on the right-hand side is after nitric oxide. When nitric oxide stimulates the endothelial cells, which are the wall lining cells, they do open up. There's more exchange of nutrients and better blood flow.
They are commonly used in supplements, often for similar purposes, but they have different mechanisms and characteristics. Here's a comparison of their pros, their cons, their benefits, their side effects, and their recommendations.
Now, this is why an all-natural healthy diet is so important. In chickpeas, turkey breast, watermelon seeds, all types of seeds, different types of meat, this is where you're going to find natural L-arginine. Even though this seems like a synthetic supplement, with all these supplements being thrown around in these fancy pictures, this is all natural stuff that your body is designed to eat. So start eating some good healthy food and you don't need any of these supplements at all.
L-arginine. The pros of L-arginine is its nitric oxide production. It's directly involved in the synthesis or the creation of nitric oxide, which improves blood flow and can benefit cardiovascular health. It can help with exercise performance, and it may increase performance, stamina. So if I'm biking, I can bike a little bit longer. It can help with wound healing and immune function. It's been studied and can bolster the immune system potentially. Here are the cons or the side effects. It gives you some GI distress, some stomach pain. It can flare up herpes outbreaks in some studies, inconsistent absorption. There are studies questioning how effective it is. And in fact, there is one study that says it's completely worthless due to its variable absorption. Generally, people take 2 to 6 grams per day. It's best to start with a lower dose and assess your tolerance. Take it throughout the day and see how it's doing for you.
It is important to note that even though 2 to 6 grams per day are recommended, a lot of it can come in a good healthy diet. So if you're eating any seeds, meats, this is a good comment for the carnivore folks that watch this. So this is a big win for you guys, but it helps with improved cardiovascular health, erectile dysfunction. It can help with fatigue. The nitric oxide specifically opens up the blood vessels, helping with wound healing, anti-inflammation. The side effects, unfortunately, though, it can lower blood pressure if you take too much and can cause some stomach irritation. The studies for erectile dysfunction are actually pretty good for 3-month use right before. They were not as effective as Viagra or the PDE5 inhibitors, for example, but they are for a viable alternative for mild to moderate erectile dysfunction.
But now we're getting to L-citrulline. The pros and benefits of L-citrulline are its conversion to L-arginine. L-citrulline is converted to L-arginine in the body, which produces nitric oxide. So why not just go with L-arginine? Well, studies show that taking L-arginine, it's not absorbed as well as L-citrulline. You want L-citrulline to be absorbed and then converted to L-arginine. Some studies show that taking L-citrulline is probably the better option.
So the foods are very similar. It's the same seeds, same meats. I like to think of L-citrulline kind of like a carrier molecule, just like food is, to help get L-arginine into our stomachs and our blood flow. Once it's in there, then they both do the same thing.
It also helps with enhanced blood flow, exercise performance, and recovery, just like L-arginine, because hey, it turns into L-arginine and has some more benefit. The difference is L-citrulline is absorbed, then gets converted, so it's more predictable and you get better absorption throughout your body. The cons and the side effects are, well, it's actually tolerated a little bit better. There's fewer GI issues, less gassiness, but there is a delayed effect. Because you take it, it doesn't kick in as quickly. It needs to be converted from L-citrulline to L-arginine, so the effects are not immediate. And the research is promising, but like L-arginine, there needs to be better comprehensive studies. It's not proven that it does a whole lot of anything, but the studies that do show that it works, 3 to 6 grams per day is what's recommended. It can be taken all at once or divided into doses.
L-citrulline is very similar to L-arginine, except I like to think about it as a transport molecule. It gets into your blood system better and more predictably than L-arginine, and then they do the same effect. It just takes a little bit longer, but it's found in meat, it's found in nuts, it's found in a lot of fruit. It has improved cardiovascular function, erectile dysfunction, can help with wound healing. That nitric oxide opens up blood vessels, but as a result, it can cause some low blood pressure, some allergies and interactions, and some gastrointestinal problems. So be aware. For erectile dysfunction, L-citrulline was actually really good as well. It's not quite as good as the medications like Viagra, but for mild to moderate cases, the results were very effective in dilating and opening up the blood vessels. Just take it a little bit earlier than L-arginine.
So the comparison of L-citrulline and L-arginine is that L-citrulline is probably more effective according to most studies. It has better absorption and it gets converted to L-arginine. It just takes a little bit longer to convert. And when I look at a lot of the pre-supplements and things being sold, it's probably a little bit more L-citrulline. It has fewer side effects, less gassiness, less GI issues. Both can be effective. L-arginine kicks in a little bit quicker, but has more GI issues, worse absorption. L-citrulline takes a little bit longer to kick in, and we're only talking like half an hour. It has less gassiness, a little bit more effective. So here's what I do practically. L-citrulline, studies do show that it does help, especially with aerobic activity. It can potentially help in wound care. It can potentially help in peripheral arterial disease. This is not a permanent effect. It does increase the blood flow a little bit, but these are more lab studies. They're more mouse studies. What I do is get a pre-workout. For most people watching this, you're working out, you're exercising. You want to get a pre-workout. So I use NutriCost. I find they have pretty good prices. Hey, I'm not getting paid to say this, I promise. Some people do send me free stuff, and this is how I got this. But I have been using a pre-workout for a little while, and it actually makes a pretty big difference. When I take these, I can feel a little bit of tingling. I have a ton of energy. I can feel my heart like amping up. When you're tired in the morning, I like to hit the wrong machine. This definitely helps me out. You know why? It has some caffeine in it. The caffeine obviously gives you a little bit of energy. It has L-citrulline in it. So the L-citrulline is in the dosage that's prescribed. It gives you that extra kick. I can actually feel some of that tingling with the blood flow. Now there's another supplement called beta-alanine, which is also in here.
Beta-alanine is very effective in raising a molecule called carnosine in our muscles. This functions to delay fatigue, muscle endurance, muscle gain. It helps with muscle gain because you're able to work out longer and harder. As a result, this helps with getting more fit. 2 to 5 grams per day is recommended. And you can see in that chart that just went by, it is found in meats just like the other molecules we talked about earlier. The one downside is it does create paresthesias. That means your muscles tingle. That's completely safe, but it does feel very weird for a lot of people.
This is known to also enhance endurance and reduce muscle fatigue. Beta-alanine is in here as well. Creatine's not in here, but creatine for athletes is another huge beneficial supplement. And if you haven't heard about creatine, check that out below. It's probably the most studied and the most effective supplement. The studies are extremely safe, extremely beneficial. Check out my detailed guide on creatine use. Creatine is probably my number one go-to athletic supplement. It's made the biggest differences for me, and I think a lot of people would agree. There is L-citrulline in here. There's amino acids, branched-chain amino acids. There's some vitamins like B vitamins. There's flavors. There's sweeteners. It's pretty low in sugar. I don't think there's any calories in here. I think one scoop is 5 calories, so there's no real sugar in here. But the reality is, instead of getting L-citrulline by itself, if you're going to be active, maybe just get a pre-workout. I link some of my favorites. I think NutriCost is a pretty good quality, validated one. The prices are probably the cheapest on Amazon. It's a pretty good option. I go with NutriCost for a lot of my supplements, and I link my favorites down below. It does taste pretty good. You just put it in water. You chug it, you get all this stuff that I'm talking about.
And if you're here for the erectile dysfunction, even though I'm a podiatrist and this is not my specialty, It is very effective for mild to moderate cases, not quite as strong as Viagra and its competitors because it is a different medication, but it does dilate and open your blood vessels. Just give it some time ahead of time.
Now just be aware, when you take this, there is some tingling because it's opening up your blood vessels. The beta-alanine does this, the L-citrulline does this, the caffeine does this. Start with a tiny little scoop. Don't take the full scoop at the beginning. See how your body tolerates it. Let me know if this stuff's working for you. Tell me if I'm shilling out to the big NutriCost manufacturers. I love hearing your opinions. And check out my creatine video if you haven't already.